My name is Kimberly Kennedy. I am the chair of the Grand Canyon Synod Diaconia Steering Committee. Diaconia is a Christian lay education program begun by a Lutheran pastor in the 1970s to support the work of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America.
I chose to do Diaconia mostly for my own personal reasons. There was a time, well, for about 20 years or so, that I was out of the Lutheran Church, and I missed the educational part that is so important in Lutheranism. So I did it to fill in parts of education that I was missing and to tie things together.
The instructors and knowledge that they brought to each of the classes, and I can't say that I had any particular instruction that I really didn't like.
Well, one of the classes we had to take was visitation, and I wasn't real excited about that because a lot of visitation was talking about listening. And I discovered that after church on Sunday mornings, I would get into a conversation with somebody which before might have been, oh yeah, that's interesting, and then let's go get dinner. But now, well, no, somebody has something they want to say, so forget what I need to do. You know, Diaconia has taught me that it's important that I'm someone they can talk to, and they feel they can, so.
My name is Paul Block, and I'm the executive director of the Diaconia program here in the Grand Canyon Synod. Well, I've been a part of Diaconia for 20 years, initially in metropolitan New York area, where I served also as the executive director there and helped renovate the program there. And then when I arrived in Las Vegas, in 2016, through prayer and conversation, we decided to build the Diaconia program here in the Grand Canyon Synod.
People could take these classes in order to be a help for the pastor. I've been a solo pastor most of my career. In those instances where I had good lay leadership and participation were the best experiences for me. For instance, in one of my congregations, what we would call a lay deacon coming out of this program would preach every fifth Sunday. And she was good at it and she enjoyed it. That's what she was called to do.
You know, we take classes for our job. We take classes and things like CPR. We take classes in order to graduate and move on into adulthood. Why should we not take classes for the most meaningful aspect of our lives, which is our Christian faith?
People participating in the Diaconia program can discover they have gifts that they never knew they had.
Well, my appeal to younger generations would be if you're willing to kind of open yourself up to learning, you can kind of deepen your faith and have that groundswell of forming your identity in your 20s as opposed to waiting until your 60s. I think most people that are taking the classes now maybe wish they had done it 20 years ago.
I have good news to announce that after over 40 years, the Diaconia program has been reimagined. The new program is called Growing in Faith, the Diaconia program. The first year of study will be called the Foundation Year. Following the Foundation Year, two practical education tracks will be offered entitled Road to Service and Faith Formation. Additional courses will be available to past graduates and current students as continuing education and will be a combination of in-person and online hybrid classes, some available at a national level.
The Growing in Faith Foundation Year classes will be available for the September and May 2023 course year. Visit www.diaconia.education for updates.